to the Actors Workshop's production of An Evening of One Acts. At this time, I'd like to go please silence your cell phones.
Silence your cell phones, please.
Yep. Got it up in the front. Up close and personal. Right, there's two exits to the theater, one of which is the door you entered, and another door down the hallway to the left. And please look forward to the upcoming Actors Workshop's production of Total Abandon. Coming up at the end of June. So sit back, relax, and enjoy An Evening of One Acts.
Nice, you're welcome.
Too scared to move these things from this home we made. So many good memories and some fateful mistakes. And I know that you love me still, but we're not the same.
Hey, honey. Hey, what are you doing up this late, huh? What, you can't sleep?
No. What are you doing home so late?
Oh, I had an emergency meeting with a client, and he called me and he was beyond distraught. He sounded suicidal, so you know, I told him I'd pay him a home visit. And you know what? We made a really great breakthrough.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's those emergency visits that you do the most work for your client. Yeah, it was a proud moment. You know, nothing like talking someone down off the ledge.
You know, I read in this magazine today, it said that when your man is lying to you, they come up with these elaborate details to their stories that leave you no room for interrogation.
Oh, yeah? All right, well, you come on with this, all right? I'm not doing this with you. I am not lying, and it's not my job to convince you otherwise,
All right, no, okay. Your first lie is that it was a man, because if it was a woman, you know, I'd question, who is she? Why are you at her house so late? So you got, you covered your ground there. Then your second lie...
Oh, you give me a fucking break, please.
All right, your second lie is that it was a home visit, because if you said you stayed late at the office, you know I'd call the office and they'd tell me you're not there. So then I would catch you in a lie. And then, so that's why you got even smarter and said it was a home visit. You know, and you're doing all of this to just cover the fact that you're fucking one of your clients.
You know, you gotta stop reading those magazines, you know that? No, they're written by men-hating women. To try to brainwash once normal women into getting divorces over some fucking imaginary marital issue or affair. You know, you should try reading a real book and how not to be paranoid or something. I got a few psych books I could lend you if you want.
Why aren't you taking me seriously?
What?
What's wrong with me that you're not taking me seriously?
Look, I don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, you fucking do. I'm getting too old for you, so why don't you just come out and say it?
What? You're younger than me, Steph. Right? That doesn't make any sense, okay? I'm 56. You're 31. It's like rings on a tree here, okay?
Doesn't it make sense, though? You did it first to Mallory. She got too old for you, so you went out looking for some young, dumb 21-year-old like me, looking for some old man to take care of her. You left her for me.
Because I fell in love with you. I mean, what are you, crazy? What, you think I would be that shallow just to pick you because
now
you were
looking
young?
You're for your next victim, so if that's the case, what? I'll take my divorce
papers
and be on
my
way.
Oh, wait, so you now, you think you're a victim? How? Huh? You live in a house that I pay for. You drive a car that I bought for you. You have every single fucking shoe that you could ever imagine.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? I wonder who paid for those, huh? You don't even have to work. And now you act like I kept you on as some kind of prisoner? Well, you know what, sweetheart? This door is always open, okay? You're welcome here as long as you want to be here. But I am not going to tolerate you taking all my money and accusing me of cheating, all right? I'm not going to fucking deal with that.
You're listing all of these things, the shoes, the car, the house, like it means anything. You're fucking somebody else. Well, is just some kind of gold digger now?
Well, you're trying to make me out to be some fucking predator.
You're not a predator, okay? I'm sorry, you're not. You think you're so deserving of some young, hot little thing at every stage in your life, but I mean, look at you. I mean, we're out of your league. Why would we pick you when We two can have our own young, hot, successful man that at least has the stamina for us in bed.
Yeah, okay, you hear yourself right now. Because you're not making any sense, okay? You're calling yourself a victim, all right? You're making me out to be some disgusting old man. You're fucking crazy.
I'm not fucking crazy. I saw what you did to her, and now you're doing it to me. You think because you have a PhD in crazy people, you're just better than everyone else. Maybe you're the mentally fucked up.
Oh, wait. I'm mentally fucked up?
Yeah.
Oh, and yet you have no proof of any of this, and you're the one who's hysterical. Now, I do everything for you, and you got some fucking nerve coming at me from this direction. I gave up my whole life for you. My wife, okay, my kids. I didn't have to do that. You could have easily been some skanky secretary that... Ah! Yeah. You good now? What, you feel better for this? Huh?
What's her name?
I don't know what you... Oh.
What's her name?
I am not cheating on you, okay? Come on. This is
what's
crazy.
Her fucking what? Name?
What are you talking about? What
is her name? Why won't you just tell me what her fucking name is?
Hey, you wanna know her fucking name? I'll tell you her fucking name! Alright! You want it? It's Jessica! It's not important.
No, it is. How old is she?
She's 21. Look,
she is.
Look, Steph, it's nothing that
no,
you did, okay?
No, spare me. I don't know. I guess I thought I was special or some shit, but I'm just as fucking dumb as
no,
you.
No, no, you're not, Steph.
No, I really
no, Steph,
have.
Please don't do this. Come on, I'm sorry, all right? Please don't leave, okay? Just stay and we can work this
you
out together.
You think I'd stay with you? That's really great. That you think I'd stay with you after you slept with somebody else.
Steph, I can't let you leave like this when you're hurting, and I don't want you to go.
I don't need you.
You don't need me?
No.
You don't need me.
No.
No, come on, Steph, listen to me. Okay, I'm sorry, baby.
I don't need
all
your
right,
apology
come on,
either.
Come on, come
stop
on.
It.
We can work this out.
No, we can't. No, we can't.
Okay, look, I want you, okay? I'll stop seeing her. I can make this up to you.
Don't do that, because she can hurt me.
Now, Steph, please.
You know what?
Look, I can't.
You have issues. I don't need to tell you. That doctor, but you didn't need to take me down with them. You stole my entire youth from me, and you've probably been planning at my disposal this entire time. I don't know, I was hoping I was wrong.
Steph, come on, don't do this, please don't leave, okay?
Steph.
I didn't mean to, I just okay, She's
young. I get it. She's young.
No, Steph, come on. I just...
The doctor says, there's my pen. Now, where did I leave my thermometer? Anyway. So, the other day, I'm riding the train. Good old Long Island Railroad. Any commuters in there?
Oh, yes. Woo!
nightmare is commuting. Right? I mean, getting kicked and shoved at 6 in the morning just to get a seat. Only to have the guy next to you fall asleep on your shoulder, drool on your arm. So I'm sitting down and minding my own business. And standing a couple of feet away from me is this creepy guy staring at my crotch. Unbeknownst to me, I was sitting on the newspaper. And yes, it was the political section. So I'm minding my own business. I'm sitting there, and after a couple of minutes, this creepy guy comes up to me, and he's like, "Excuse me, sir. Are you reading that newspaper?" I look at him, and I'm like, "Does it look like I'm reading the newspaper?" He doesn't say a word. He just stands there with his mouth open like he's catching flies. So I figure, let me mess with him. I stand up. I turn the page and I sit back down. True story! Anyway, listen, folks, we're going to take a short break, but stick around. We got a great show for you tonight. Grab yourselves a drink. We'll see you back here in 15 minutes. Get me fired?
Mitch, I'm trying to help us.
Help us? You call that free-for-all helpful? What in God's name would provoke you to heckle me like that?
I'm sorry. I got under your skin, but it's part of my act.
Your act. Okay, let's get something straight. This is my gig, and I'm the master of this domain.
Why are you getting so worked up? I'm just trying to make us a little extra money.
Money? Can you spell that out for me?
I developed a formula.
Since when did you become a mathematician?
Since our savings is dwindling and I don't know what to do about it anymore.
Okay. The only formula I know that you know for sure is 2.5 ounces of development, 1.5 ounces of dye, every 4 to 6 weeks, depending on your stress levels, of course, apply to roots, and voila, you get that.
Well, since you mentioned it, voila is what attracted you to me in the first place, and I know you still love it. Listen. Our savings is almost gone, and if you just dug it out 2 more years at the local union, we'd be golden. But no, you had to have all this.
Let's not go down that road. No, you know what, now that you brought it up, let's. You agreed that I could live my life's dream to be a stand-up comic, didn't you? What? I can't
but
hear
I
you.
Think no,
situation. No buts allowed. This is what I always wanted to do and be. And when the opportunity presented itself, I jumped on the wagon. Finally, the chance to do what I was meant to do.
Yeah.
Come on. We knew that we would take a hit. We knew that we'd have to change our lifestyle, give a little less, take a little less.
I never imagined that it could be this less. Do you know I shop at Walmart now? And everything I buy has to be damaged or earn clearance. TJ Maxx, Marshalls, I can only do drive-bys. Those Quick City Getaways just to go window shopping down Fifth Avenue. It's just a dream. Huh. What kind of life is this, Mitch? I feel like Lisa Douglas from Green Acres. Do you remember that show? You are my wife. Goodbye, City Life.
It's goodbye, City Life. She says goodbye, City Life, not to her life.
Oh, who gives a crap? It feels like goodbye to everything. My feet are screaming, massage me. I'm suffering.
I know. PPD.
What?
PPD, post-pedicure disorder. Gorgeous stuff, Carol.
But it's my stuff. You see, it's different for you, Mitch, because you come out here every night and you have fun.
Fun? You think it's easy coming up with new material?
Oh, yeah.
Do you know that most nights half the audience could care less what I have to say? The other half waits for more than I have to offer. And it doesn't help that my wife gets more laughs than I do.
Well, I'm sorry, you're bruised, your ego's bruised?
My ego is well intact. It feels good to be in my kingdom.
Your kingdom? You're such a lion when you're angry. In the jungle.
Oh, no.
The mighty jungle.
Not happening, Count.
The lion. mind
nope,
sleeps
stop it.
Tonight.
No way. Too many distractions. Besides, this is a domestic issue. We'll talk about this when we're at home.
You're never home! Mitch, I know how important all of this is to you. I just wish you knew what was important. Important to me.
Okay. I'll bite.
Okay, if you're gonna have that kind of
attitude. What do you want me to do? I have to be on stage in 5 minutes.
How long have we known each other?
Oh, God. 25 years, 102 days, 14 hours, 12 minutes,
and
32 seconds. I know everything about you, every inch on you.
Do you know how lonely it is for me?
Everybody gets a little lonely
once
in a while.
But what's my purpose? I'm not needed for anything. Nobody needs me. Not even you.
You're thinking crazy again. I think the formula seeped in too deep.
Can you hear me? You haven't been paying attention.
I hear you just perfectly. How could I not?
You know, after all these years, I am still just Mitch's wife. I haven't done anything extraordinary with my life. The kids are grown, that's done. Our friends moved down south, we're still here. And Brownie died. You know, they say 50 is a new 30. Why do I feel like I'm not living in the prime of my life? What am I missing? At the end of the day, I only have you, Mitch. And you're out here doing what you love. You found your passion.
We still have a little passion of our own most Wednesday
nights.
Oh,
my God. How would you think? No, 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 no. That's just two kisses, and then one rolls over and is snoring, sleeping like a baby, and that person's not me.
Well, I'm sorry you don't get anything out of it.
What? I didn't say
you know
that.
What? It is always something with you. Can we just make it through a month? Were you just somewhat satisfied? Where the glass is half full and not half empty? Some joy, pal. Find some joy. Who am I kidding? You couldn't make it through a night, let alone a month. You know what? I think maybe you suffer from bipolar disorder. It's a joke.
I'm not laughing. You see, it's easy for you, Mitch. It's your job. You come out here, you make up the jokes, you keep the patrons entertained. I envy that. I really envy that. But me, what do? I just sit here with these papers and I make formulas up in my head. So you could do what you love and then maybe I can feel needed. Do you hear me? I am lonely.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We got a great lineup for you tonight. But before we get started, can we cut the music, please? There's something I need to say. Can we cut the music? Thank you. You know what? You're right. I haven't been paying attention. I've arrived at my destiny and I feel like a kid in a candy store, and I'm having the time of my life. But it means nothing to me if my girl feels like she's being pushed to the side. I'm sorry. Where would I be if it weren't for you pushing me to live my dream, build my confidence, believe in me as well as give me a ton of great material to work with? If it weren't for you, I'd be at home watching reruns of Everybody Loves Raymond, with a bunch of Dorito crumbs all over my chest. You've made our house a home. We raised two beautiful children together. So what if they need therapy? Nobody's perfect, right? I know that one day soon you will find your passion. And when you do, I'll be right by your side, cheering you on and supporting you every step of the way. You're my wife, my best friend, and my greatest fan. And I wouldn't trade you for the world. I just needed you to know that. Well, I guess I needed everyone to know that.
God, I think I just kissed you.
Who's stopping you, baby?
I think they like us. Maybe we should get an act together and go out on the road.
Carol, you're wrecking the moment.
I can see the marquee now. Carol and Mitch.
I think it's time for you to take your seat, babe.
I really like it up here.
Carol Ann.
Okay.
Carol Ann, ladies and gentlemen. So marriage. Marriage is hard, right? Don't know. I didn't know marriage was, you know, the floor is not a hamper. Will you ever take out the garbage without me asking? Talk anymore. You know, the great Henny Youngman used to say, take my wife, please. I don't know. I think I'll hold on to mine.
Troubling you. When we last spoke, you mentioned that you've been having some trouble sleeping. So why don't we start with that? How long has that been going on?
Yeah, I'd say it's been going on for the past few months or so. Started to get a little worse. But, you know, think it's anything to be too concerned about, you know. With my job, I work a lot of odd hours, so.
Well, odd hours can certainly contribute to sleep issues. What is it that you do?
Consultant.
So, why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself?
What's there to tell, Doc?
Right.
I think I look like your average Joe, you know? Nothing really special going on here, you know? You want to just write me something for sleep, you know? I can be on my way.
Now, listen, let's not rush into anything. That's certainly one way to go, but I'd really like to get to know a little bit more about you and figure out what's causing your sleep issues.
I gotta be straight with you, alright? Man to man, you look like a stand-up guy. I don't really want to be here. I don't know what to tell. But, let's be honest. I could have made one phone call, got my drug, my hands on any drug I want, you know? So why don't you just help me out, write me something for sleep, and I'll be on my way.
But you didn't.
I'm sorry, I didn't what?
You didn't just make a phone call. You came in here to talk, so obviously there's something bothering you. So, John, in my experience, when someone has trouble sleeping, there's usually an underlying psychological component to it. So, why don't you tell me what's really going on?
You're persistent, huh? I respect that. I'm a persistent guy myself. But, look, what's this happening from just getting up and leaving, huh? You?
Nothing. You can leave anytime you like.
Well,
free to go.
All right. You know, look, I'll play you a little game. All right. Who knows? Maybe I'll be getting something out of it, right? But I am warning you. You might not like what you hear, Doc.
30 years as a psychiatrist is very little I haven't already heard. So spill it.
Truth is, every time I go to sleep, I get like this, this terrible anxiety. Alright? Sometimes it feels like I'm gonna die. I don't know what it is, but it's like the weight of the world, you know? It's just crushing me, and my chest is collapsing in, and no matter what I do, I can't breathe.
Do you fear death, John?
Well, yeah, don't we all?
Well, I mean, is there something going on that makes you think you're gonna die soon?
I mean, when you're in my line of work, it can be kind of stressful.
And that would be consulting, right?
Like you said.
What makes consulting so stressful?
Look, Doc, if I told you, you wouldn't understand.
Try me.
Look, Doc, I really can't get into the specifics, all right? So
why not?
Let's just say the people that hire me, they hire me for my discretion.
Well, listen, anything you say in here is completely confidential. I mean, unless, of course, you were some kind of a hitman.
I'm sorry, what did you just say?
It's just a bad joke, I'm sorry.
Oh, some kind of joke. I mean, of all the things you could have said. That would cross your mind, huh? Well, now, since you brought it up, hypothetically, I'm just spitballing. If I was, in fact, a hitman, as you so eloquently put it, what could I or couldn't I say in there? Oh, I'm just kidding with you, man! You should have seen your face. It was priceless. I mean, seriously, though. The word hitman, bro. It just gives such a bad connotation. You know? It makes me seem like some kind of, I don't know, like a savage. You know? What is this, Philly?
So you are a hitman.
Oh, Doc, I think I've taken up enough of your time. It was a pleasure meeting you.
Stay. We're only only talking hypothetically. And, I know I said you could leave, but it's all hypothetical. Just stay.
All right, sure.
All right. Good. So, let me ask you. How does one, how do you get into,
I have a commitment, so we can. Truth is, I don't really know, Doc. Just sort of happened, you know? I mean, I was always big and strong, and, you know, extremely handsome, so. Just kind of took, you know? Don't get me wrong, I mean, look, I ain't stupid. I've done a lot of the things in my life, it just didn't happen that way. I'm sorry, come again?
I'm sorry. Please continue.
Truth is, Doc, I might have made one or two mistakes here. Either that, you know, I'm sure who hasn't, right? I'm sure you have, right?
A couple.
But, you know, I might have dabbled in drugs here or there. I might have hurt a few people. Shit, I've done worse than hurt people, right? I mean, I wasn't very good at school, you know, it wasn't really my thing. Couldn't really work a 9-to-5 job, you know, I'm just not that type of guy, so here I am.
So what made you start using drugs? Is it to face the reality of who you are?
I like you. I do. You're straight to the point. But no, honestly, I just like them.
Have you ever thought about killing yourself?
Oh, Jesus Christ. Where do you come up with this moment? Shit, man.
Listen, I just had to ask. So, tell me about your parents.
What's there to tell?
Are they still together? Are they alive?
They're fine. Both happily married for over 30 years, so. Look, if you're trying to blame my shitty life choices on bad parenting, Doc, you're shit out of luck.
You have any siblings or friends?
Yeah, I got a sister. But I haven't exactly talked to her in a while. And in my line of work, you don't exactly have friends, you know? So look, I think we've talked enough. You know, I'd say just write me something to sleep when I get the hell out of here, huh?
John, I can't just do that. It's important that we talk about everything. Understand you a little better, and maybe we can change you.
You're gonna change me. Maybe I don't want you to change me. Maybe I just want you to write me something to sleep, huh? Like, get the hell out of here.
John, I'm not just gonna give you something to help you do your job better. Now, if we understand why you took this line of work, maybe we can get you to do something else.
You're not hearing me, Doc. I don't want to do something else, all right? I don't want you to fix me.
John.
What?
If you want me to help you, you need to be honest with me.
What do you want me to say? Huh? You want me to cry on your shoulder?
If you need to.
Oh, get the hell out of here. You want me to say how I hate hurting people? How I hate what I do? Huh? Because the truth is, you know what I do? I hate it. Nobody should like this shit. I don't know, God or whoever, he just decided that I didn't deserve to be happy, you know? That's the way it is, right? I mean, life's unfair. You gotta do what you gotta do to survive, so that's what I did, Doc. I survived.
What makes you think God is doing this to you?
Well, he created us, right? I mean, he gets all the glory when shit goes right. Shouldn't he get some of the blame when shit goes wrong?
John, don't you think you're just using God as an excuse to blame somebody other than yourself?
I think I'm blaming the whole fucking world, Doc. So who are you to sit there and judge me, huh?
John, I'm not judging you. But I would like to know, what do you think gives you the right to hurt other people?
That's right, Doc. Both big boys, you can say it. To kill people.
Look, John, don't you see the hypocrisy? You sit there and you blame God, and yet you're playing God.
God's got nothing to do with that.
No?
No. The only times he was there when people would call out for him right before I blew their fucking brains out, huh? Never, not once. Not once did he answer them. All those people, all those innocent people, crying out for me. So, if he does exist, fuck him. He's never done a damn thing for me anyway. Wasn't there when my father used to beat me half to death every night? Wasn't there when my mother was slowly wasting away from cancer? Wasn't there when my sister died alone in a bathroom? So if he doesn't give a shit about life, why the fuck should I, huh?
Very sorry to hear all that.
Yeah, sure you are.
But that still doesn't answer why you feel like you have the right to kill people. Now look, this was a great first step for you.
You sound like you said first step.
Yeah, first step. I mean, you need more than I can just give you myself. You need extensive therapy and treatment. I mean, John, I'm happy to meet with you once a week. We'll track your progress, but You didn't think I was going to let you go back out there and keep doing what you do, did you? I mean, this isn't The Sopranos where I look the other way and we talk about your mother every week.
Oh, Jesus Christ. God. I knew this was a bad idea.
No, John, this is great.
Oh, Doc, I'm in bed for you.
What?
Look, you seem like a nice guy. I mean it, but you get what I do, right?
You know,
I'm thinking of some kind of little girl coming in here spilling out my guts every week to a psychiatrist.
This is all confidential, John.
I just can't take that chance, Doc. I mean, you understand, right?
John,
you really should just
John,
give me
what
a
are you doing?
Pills.
John!
Crawling all over the place, pissing everywhere, shitting out shoes, just watching us with those beady fucking little eyes.
Fucks, nothing fucks all around us.
Yo, Steve. This has got nothing to do with just leaving you, right?
What? No. This doesn't have anything to do with that much.
Yeah, you sure? Cause it's shit like this while she's not around no more.
You don't know what you're talking about, right?
Yo, you came on too hard, man. Like, people don't need that shit.
What do you mean I came on too hard?
You were too clingy.
I was not clingy.
What did you think was going to happen?
You know what? Maybe you should just go and get me some more traps. That might be helpful, all right?
You want me to get you more traps? You want to play Crocodile Dundee and mouse hunting and shit? I have to get you more traps. You get your own damn traps.
Just make yourself useful.
You know what? You do this shit every time. Every damn time, Steve.
Every time.
Yeah, every time something happens that doesn't go your way, you find like one little thing and you become obsessive over it.
I'm not obsessive, right? I'm just going every single second my time and energy attached to this motherfucker.
Have you been drinking?
Yeah, a few little shots.
How many of you, Steve?
72.
My guy, my man, okay, listen up. Okay, we live in an apartment in the middle of the Bronx, okay? Like, we're not the only people who live here. There's bound to be like 1 or 2 mice. Who cares? It's not a big deal, okay? Don't be a pussy, my man. Grow up here. No, like, seriously, no one gives a shit, no one cares.
You saying there might be more of these motherfuckers?
Hey, see, hey, you, my asshole!
I'm gonna get this
No! Okay, you know what? I came in here to tell you something, I fucking forgot, and I don't give a shit no more, okay? I'm over this shit, Steve. I'm serious. I'm going to my room.
Wait,
I'm gonna go fucking relax.
Marsh,
clean this shit up. Clean it up,
Steve. You don't want
Steve.
Me to go in there, Marsh.
Why? What the fuck? What the fuck is that, Steve? What the fuck?
Mrs. Thomas, surprise!
What the fuck?
Yeah, that happened. White guy tied up. Okay, so, you see, he came up here to complain about the sound, and we started arguing, and I figured until I catch this little shit, it would be easier if I got rid of any distractions. You get it, right, Miss Perkinson?
Are you that fucking stupid?
Come on, I think you're overreacting this a little bit.
Overreacting? Overreacting is tying up our nail and putting him in my bedroom because there's nobody in the world!
So, you don't think it was a good idea?
What the fuck?
Are you
kidding me? Are you kidding me?
Maybe you should go for like a walk or something.
Oh,
okay, sorry.
I can't mother me, mama. Mommy, do you think I can move back in?
control?
Spent the night at my brother's.
Come over here.
I'd rather not.
Did you at least think about what I said?
That's all I've been thinking about.
And?
But yeah, in a perfect world, I could run away with you and never come back. But this isn't a perfect world, and you know that.
You're just scared, okay? I have all this money. We can do this. You have nothing to worry about.
I do have things to worry about. Look, you act like you're my whole world, and I have nothing to leave behind.
I know, but I mean, you can't blame me for wanting you to come with me.
I can't blame you for getting this fucking situation in the first place, can I?
You know the consequences of what I do.
I didn't think you might have fucking run away from the fucking feds.
What did you think it meant? Am I in jail?
Cover for you? Look, being an alibi, not this. I mean, this is bigger than anything I've ever thought about.
I run one of the biggest underground arms trades in this city. This isn't fucking weed we're talking about.
Look, I always thought if you got in this situation, we could outrun them. But I never thought it would come to fruition. This is...
I can't sort this one out, okay? No amount of sweet-talking, no amount of fucking cleavage is gonna convince them that I didn't fucking do this. And I'm not going away for something if I can outrun them.
You shouldn't have to outrun them in the first place.
What?
You got careless.
I did not get careless, okay? It was that little fucking snitch who was afraid to do your two behind bars through my fucking name out there.
You put him in that situation to begin with. What the fuck did you expect?
I expect fucking loyalty. Especially from you.
So you're saying because I don't want to fake my death and go west and I'm not loyal?
I'm just saying you claim to be a ride or die and you're not about to do either.
If those fucks came to me, you know I'd cover for you. I'd take a fucking bullet for you. But I never promised that I'd leave my life and my family behind for you. I can't make a decision like this overnight. It's not that simple.
It would be that simple if you actually loved me. Do I? Look, I did not think I'd be asking someone like you to do this, but I mean, here I am. I mean, most of the men I dated, I mean, they thought I was fucking crazy, or I don't know, they were emasculated by my power, and I mean, you thought it was fucking sexy. Do you remember what you said to me after I told you?
Refresh my memory.
Well, first you gave me that douchey fucking attitude, and you were like, okay, and then you were like, so get me a bigger gun and I'll always be behind you. I mean, you were ready to take down any motherfucker that even tried to come at me, and now this? I mean...
I don't know, Chelsea.
I have all of this money saved. I have new passports, new IDs. I even packed all your things.
You packed my things?
Yeah.
That's pretty bold. What if I need them? What's on the other side?
I need to leave today. With or without you.
Really got all this planned out, huh?
I just wanted it to be easy when you make the right decision.
So what's your name gonna be?
What do you mean?
You fake death. For Wes, you're gonna need a new name, right?
Well, I mean, you know, I always thought I looked like a Melanie.
That's right. What about me?
Carlito.
Carlito?
Oh, fuck. I'm sorry. It's badass, though. It's totally badass.
Okay. Carlito. So what's the plan? Figure that's... blood behind, disappear without a trace. That's it.
You know we're going out in style. Okay, so first, we're gonna go on this dope African safari, okay? We're gonna take a selfie on your phone, the hippo behind us. Motherfuckers are huge. They kill more people a year than great white sharks, okay? So when they find your phone, they're gonna see this hippo in the background and be like, yo, that fucker ate them. And then that's it.
That's it. Yeah, they said women could drive you crazy, but yo.
No, really though. I have a boat waiting for us. We're gonna leave on it and meet up this other boat. The boat we left on is gonna sink and they'll never find the bodies. That's it. We're out of here.
Whatever you do, wherever you go, I'm in. I'll always be here. That, or a bigger gun.
Alright, I mean, anything you want. Bigger gun, nicer car. I got you as long as you got me, you know that.
I know. I don't know what happened. Can you please just help me get this off, please?
Whatever. Oh, shit, you're stuck.
No shit, Sherlock!
You're making fun of me, but you're the one with his balls crushed.
Look, come on, can you please just help me get this off? I tried to roll it up, but then it hit the stick in my pocket.
Let me see what we got here.
Of my...
How long you been here?
I don't know, 15, 20 minutes? Can you help me get it off, please? Stop looking at the bandana! Just help me get it off!
You know, with the loss of circulation and that bar cut right across the meat and potatoes, it can prove very, very dire to one and or both of your parts.
What the hell are you saying?
You might lose your dick.
No! I need that!
Well, let me call somebody.
No. Who are you calling? Please, just get back here. Please lift it off. Please.
You know what? You're right, Jay. This could wait.
Wait, what? There's no waiting. This is my dick we're talking about.
You hardly use it. You're clearly not going anywhere.
What could be more important than my dick?
Jay, I see what you do here late at night.
Wait, what are you talking about?
The videos.
You have cameras?
Yeah. And I've been meaning to tell you your ritual.
Wait, you mean the thing with the...
Yeah, the naked yoga thing.
That's not a dance, all right? That's training.
Whatever it is, it's done.
You wouldn't know anything about it, but the tantric positions I put my body into can only be expressed whilst nude, okay? So, if the only time I can do that is at 2:15 a.m. alone in the gym, well, then goddammit, that's when I'll do it.
Dude, why can't you just like darts or something?
Why can't you just accept your son for the way that he is?
Stepson. And I'm kind of seeing your naked ass upside down. This way, the other leg that way. Very disturbing.
Well, why are you looking at my naked ass?
I don't know.
Bored? Is that it?
I'm no doctor, but let me take a look.
Look, you're gonna look at my.
Yeah.
No.
I'm your father, don't worry about it.
Step. Oh my god, what?
Oh, dude!
What? You can't make that face and then not say anything? What?
It's purple! It's purple!
So, like a good purple?
There is no good purple, it's purple!
Well, So what do we do?
I gotta show everybody.
Oh,
Sarah!
Oh,
Sarah!
It's over, Gene. I got him now.
You can't be serious. Look, I really think you're making a big mistake.
Oh, am I? Let's just see how the rest of the world thinks about this, why don't we?
Okay, yeah, but if you find them and they get leaked into the public, then you'll undo history and shit's gonna hit the fan. Not to mention, you'll probably never see the light of day ever again.
Well, I guess that would just be too fucking bad. Fuck. These aren't them. I thought these were it.
Thought these were what?
Don't play with me. You know what I'm talking about. Where are they?
You mean these?
Give them to me.
Why? What are you going to do with them?
What do you think I'm going to do with them? I need to open people's eyes to this conspiracy, Gene. They need to know the truth. Besides, it'll be for the good of us all.
So what are you going to do? Pass it off to WikiLeaks or something like that? How do you know people will accept these as real? Or even read them?
Lots of people read the other files instantly when the government released them to the vault. You don't think they'll do the same when I put the icing on the cake here? This is the sweetest part of it all, and I think everyone wants a taste of what's to come. So come on, give it here. It's not like you're the one who's going to be causing trouble anyway. Listen, you've got nothing more to hide. At least from me.
Fine. I guess you're right. But there's something you should know.
Okay, what's that?
I pulled these papers from my agency in the FBI. It looks like they caused quite a stir when they presented their findings to the investigations committee. I think you're gonna have a harder time than just getting this info out onto the news, Mark. You okay? You look a little bit puzzled.
I don't get it.
No?
How's this possible?
That's what I thought. Or at least I should have, and that's why I'm thinking you're making a huge mistake by trying to put this stuff out. There's a reason why we can't just let this out into the world, Mark. Some of us are still out there. So what's wrong?
The FBI has concluded that La Cosa Nostra is primarily responsible for the assassination of JFK. However, the CIA has concluded that the Cuban government is also responsible for the assassination of the president. It has been determined that La Cosa Nostra and the Cuban government conspired to assassinate President Kennedy under the negligence of Soviet intelligence? What is this?
Go on.
The FBI and the CIA, as of this writing, has declared this plot to be an inside job with outside help, based on premeditated efforts, but it's undetermined how the government allowed this assassination to occur. What's going on here? I know the mafia didn't have the warm and fuzzies for Kennedy, and I knew the Cubans were out for vengeance, but something's missing. This isn't exactly what conspiracy theorists have longed for. Is this unfinished?
Yeah, there's more to it than that. You just got through the non-government plotters. It goes way beyond the mafia's hitmen. And we can't just put this out into the world. Some of us are still out there.
Still out there? What, in hiding? In government? Where, who,
how? It's not that easy to say exactly, but we have a reason for trying to keep these things quiet.
Gene, what are you trying to say to me? That this is ongoing? And what do you mean by some of us? You're not the Gene I used to know.
Look,
please just tell me what's going on here.
I know this is going to be hard to hear, Mark. But then again, there's not much I can say. And you won't really have to worry about it in the end.
What are you saying? Tell me and don't lie to me.
Okay, yes, the Mafia in Cuba did play a part in this. But what you wouldn't know is that our peers had a part in this, too. Everything you're reading there isn't quite true.
What do you mean?
So the other theories are true, okay, but it's not that simple to say. Okay, the FBI has concluded that La Cosa Nostra is primarily responsible for the assassination of JFK. The first point in that bulletin is false.
Huh?
the CIA had also concluded that the Cuban government had a part in the assassination. An inside job, but outside help. It is undetermined how the government allowed this assassination to occur. Come on, Mark, none of this makes
sense.
I don't understand.
Is any of it or is it not true? No one's going to understand this.
Well, it's not that it isn't true or not, but rather that it's ongoing. The truth is in the making as we speak.
What do you mean?
We are still working on shaping this country's future. All those decades ago, we had to cover our tracks so that our plan could be carried out to perfection. Once it's complete, and soon it will be, the truth will be made. History will be made.
Us. We. Yeah. You're not the Gina I used to know.
We are the Majestic 12. And soon to be the 13. We were once a union of scientists, military leaders, and policymakers. Now we're the shadow presidents, the cyber Judases, the Machiavellians, the perfectibilists. And you, Mark, you're just a stumbling block that needs to get out of the way.
You're a part of this. Why?
For the betterment of this country. And for my initiation. And this is it. I'm sorry, Mark. You really deserve better.
Was this all a play for you? Hell, you wrote this yourself just to throw me off, didn't you? No wonder why none of it made sense. You knew I'd be a nuisance trying to solve this case.
I'm really sorry.
What were we? Huh? Did I mean anything to you?
Yeah, of course you did. It's not like I didn't have feelings for you, Mark, but this is what came of my life. I didn't have much of a choice.
Oh, it seems like you did. And you made your choice. But that's okay. You're getting what you wanted, aren't you?
This is not what I had wanted. But I do now.
What are you talking about?
I didn't choose this, Mark, okay? You put me in this spot. You were the one who paid to have me hired, not even considering what I was capable of. Also, you could further your own career. And then you kept me as your side chick all the while, telling me how unique and beautiful I was. And you know what? I forgave you. But I can't forget. So you got what you want. And now you get what you deserve.
Jean. Look, I'm sorry. I really am. I did mean those things that I said. You have to believe me. Look, it's the work. It got in the way. This case, it put me out to be the bad guy. You have to believe me. Listen, I still care about
you. Oh, no, look, I've heard this from you before, Mark. This ends right here.
Jean, what are you doing? Put down the gun.
No! This is what I came to. I can't let you leave, Mark.
Put down the gun. You're crazy. This is insane. And you know, you're right. This is enough. And I'm getting out of here.
No. Why don't you take a seat, Mark? Let's talk. I'll let you leave. If you riddle me once more like you used to. And then we never have to see each other ever again.
Okay. What's that?
if in the first sentence you utter, you speak the truth, I'll let you leave. You will have left with no evidence, and you cannot return, but you will have left with your life. But surely, if you were to lie to me like you used to, I'll shoot you. Right here, right now. Know what happened to you.
You are going to shoot me.
Yeah.
welcome to Heaven or Hell Cafe. What can I get you?
You know, my father owns this coffee shop.
Oh, I did know that.
And I own fields that the coffee beans come from.
I knew that too.
And I own the chemical plants that produces the coffee cups, the sleeves, the lids, and the environmentally conscious biodegradable paper straws.
I knew that, and I also knew that you weren't going to order a thing.
That's right. No, I'm second thought. I'll handle the strongest thing that you got.
You sure about this?
Don't I own the coffee fields?
Okay. Okay, here you go.
Never tried this one before.
Good morning. Hey, welcome to Mineral Cafe. What can I get you?
We'll keep these up, juice boxes.
Oh. I'm sorry, no. Strictly adult guest beverages and pastries.
How about like lunch or bars or a Twinkie made from food?
No. Here we go. Here is a nice whipped creamy thing.
How do you know?
My reader. Bye-bye. Jesus. Oh, sorry, not you. Good morning. Fuck off. Give me black coffee. Okay. You got it.
Don't get that fuck attitude.
No attitude. Okay. Can't this place run any faster? Okay. All right. Here's your coffee.
What the fuck did you do to this piece of shit?
Nothing. Okay? And here is a nice Xanax.
Fucking asshole.
I see that some ribbons of
of coffee and some danishes.
Okay, okay, all right, all right. All right, here you go, here you go. Take it off, there you go. Thank God you're here.
Always yes, ready to you. Take your place.
Good one. I'm exhausted.
Try not to rest.
Hey, that's very clever. Oh, hey, listen. Could you not turn up the thermostat? Okay, it's melting all the icing off the cinnamon buns every shift you're on.
Oh, I'm sorry to inconvenience you, but it's like a freezer in here.
Oh, yeah, speaking of freezer, okay? Stay out of the back room.
Okay, yeah.
Well, there's always no ice left every time you're on.
Yeah, I get it. Didn't you say you wanted it all?
I do. Oh. How you doing?
Talk like an angel, but I can't hide. Talk like an angel, but I got one. You're the devil in disguise. Oh, yes, you are. Devil in disguise.